If you run marketing for your company or website, you know how important it is to measure the performance of your marketing. Using Google Tag Manager is not as easy as they might tell us. It requires a lot of coding knowledge if you do have a custom need. Luckily, there are tools out there which can help us set up measurements a lot easier. Today's product showcase is HockeyStack, which can help you set up funnels, segments, goals, and even surveys. HockeyStack works great for all types of companies running marketing, whether it's paid marketing or you are all in for the organic SEO traffic. So without further ado, let's dive into HockeyStack and let me show you how you can measure your marketing. Signing into HockeyStack, this is the dashboard where we have most of our information. And this is also the general analytics view, which you will notice later in the video. But here on the dashboard, we can see the sessions, which has been in this period chosen up here, and the amount of users. This means that two users have had two sessions each, which of course adds up to four sessions. There's been seven page views and we have a bounce rate on 75%. We have an average 1.75 pages per session. The average session duration is 2 minutes and 14 seconds. Then we have the sources down here where we can see where people are coming from, how people are using the website. This is mainly desktop. We can see what pages are visited. This is only the front page. And then down here, you can see automatic goals. This means that all people who enters this website, in this case, it is panta.ai, every action that they do when they click on something, HockeyStack will think that this could be a goal. And therefore they suggest this as a goal. You can see that often there's irrelevant things such as question two, that's actually a HockeyStack thing. Then we have next, also a HockeyStack thing, surveys. So a lot of these are actually within HockeyStack and is irrelevant for me to track as HockeyStack is already doing it. However, if we wanted to, this one is quite relevant and I have already set it up, but just for the sake of this video, we could say define goal here. We could give this a name. And then we could add the goal and we would then have the goal created. We will see that just in a moment. Now, if we move on to the users module here, we can see the two users who has visited the website. And we can of course click in and see way more information about them, like where the location were, their language they have in their browser, what device they used, the OS, what browser, and so on. We can see a lot of information here. And over here, we can see what they did. You can see that first session they had, they viewed a survey, which I will show you how you do within HockeyStack. Then they clicked on Made with HockeyStack, and then they went back to view the survey again. In the next session here, they did a lot more. They actually completed the survey. And in the last session they had here, all they did was that they went to the front page and then they scrolled 26%. And then they stop there. So you can see we have all of the history, and this is basically tracking the users about what they are doing on the website. It is not the same way as Hotjar is doing it, but it is similar in some sense because we get all of the actions that the users actually do. Now moving on to the goals module, this is similar to analytics, but it's just way more easy to work with. Here you can see we have two goals right now. The bottom one here is the one we set up via the dashboard. And the top one is one I have had for some time. So we can see the top one here has one, which means that the goal has been submitted one time. We have endless percentage. I think that's a mistake because it has been, as you saw, two people on the website, but only one of them has clicked sign up to learn more, which means that it should say 50% in the conversion rate, maybe even 25% because we had four sessions. But we can, of course, click on the name. And then you can see that we are now on the dashboard again. However, now we are only seeing information about the goal that we just clicked on. We can see that the person came from direct, which means that they entered the website directly. They then had a bounce rate on 100%, which is terrible. They watched one page and they were there for 1 minute and 54 seconds. Now going back to the goals module, if we just click this one out a little bit, we can see here that it has been submitted one time, which means that this one has been clicked one time. I'll show you in a moment how we set up a goal. And then we can see the referrers, where they're coming from. This is direct, of course, again, see in the dashboard. Now, if we want to set up a goal, this is where it happens. So you give the goal a name and then you choose what defines this goal, and it can be multiple steps that needs to be fulfilled in order for your goal to be fulfilled, of course. So here you can see that we can click with the selector. This is meant as a CSS selector, or click with text, which is great. This is one I like to use, or they viewed a certain page or custom goal. So for instance, we can say that if they click on a button with the text sign up in this case, well, then it's a goal for us because then they went to the sign up page. And then of course we need to give it a name. Now we have it added here and you can see that it's 0% because no one has clicked on sign up, and it's 0 times. But this is how easy it is to set up a goal within HockeyStack. And of course, as you saw, you can add multiple steps for your goal. Now, working with marketing, you're probably also working with funnels, which means that you want to set up a funnel so you can track how the performance is of the different marketing campaigns. And for that, they also have a funnel module. My funnel here is very simple. I just want them to enter the front page and then I want them to sign up to learn more. This one I have set up and we can see here that 2 people entered the front page, but only 1 signed up. So this is a conversion rate of 50%. It is a test case because 50% is unrealistic, but this is just to show you. And of course, if we want to see more information, we can of course click on edit. And then down here we see the same, but here you can see how I set it up. I have made 2 steps where I've said that the first step is that they need to enter the front page of my website, and it needs to be a view of exactly panta.ai. The next step, and this is where there is some synergy within HockeyStack. Here I just chose the goal, which I have previously set up as you just saw in the goal module. So here I don't have to make a duplicate. This is the same goal, which means that I can add it and then I can collect all of the data around that goal. But it is straightforward, very simple. You can add as many steps as you want. Again, we see the same here with click the selector, click with text, view, and then we have the goals or view a certain page. It is very simple. And then we can of course see if I had multiple steps, that would also be shown here. But it is a great way, let's say that you have a sign up form on 5 different steps. It is a great way to see what step do they actually fall off on, where do they leave, because then maybe you need to optimize that step a little bit. Now, if you want to know your target group a little bit more, or you want information about your target group, you can set up segments. In here, it is quite simple and you have a lot of properties that you can filter on. So of course, this is all your users, all your visitors from your website. And all of these, you can say that if they have done a certain action, I want to do something with them. So here we can say that all who have not done enter, let's not say that one, let's say sign up to learn more in the last 7 days, define segment. So now we have 2 segments. The first one has 3 sessions within, and the last one just have 1 session within. But this is just segments that we can use, and it's a way to filter your target group within multiple segments. Now, if you want to run surveys on your website, this is also possible within HockeyStack. You can see here I've made a test survey, which has been seen 3 times, and 1 has responded to it. It is very simple to set up a survey. As you can see here, I have made 3 questions, again for test purposes. You can see the responses in here and the analytics around. Again, this is a little bit the same view as we saw within the funnel view, where we see the different steps and we can see if someone doesn't finish the survey. Let's say that 50% falls off on question 2. Maybe I should optimize or change question 2 a little bit, maybe even remove it in order for people to get all the way through the survey. Setting up a survey is quite simple. You just click new survey up here and then you choose whether it needs to be shown only on desktop, phone, tablet, or all of them, what pages it needs to be shown on, when it needs to be launched. It can be after 10 seconds, it can be immediately. And then of course you can add questions and you have all sorts of different types of questions. Let's say you want an NPS score of your software or your website. This is also possible within here. So this is great. However, let me just show you. Here you can see the survey on panta.ai and you can see the styling is a bit off and they are showing made with HockeyStack, even though I do have a paid plan. So just be aware of that. But except for that, it is quite easy to get through. You just, of course, answer the questions and then you move through the different types of questions. You choose an option and then you press send. You do not get a success message. That could be a thing they could work in, but it is as simple as that. And if we do want more extensive information about our survey, you can see again, we have the analytics here. Again, it looks like the dashboard. It is the dashboard, but it is filtered with only containing the survey information. Of course, as I'm showing it on the front page and I'm showing it to everyone immediately, it is exactly a copy of the dashboard, but it is just to show you. The last tab they have here, which I have not been able to get working, is their insights. This one is very interesting. What Insights is doing is that it's collecting a lot of data which it gets from your website by tracking the users. And then based on the way that the users uses your website, it will suggest you ways that you can track them by suggesting funnels or goals that you can set up. And in here, you will get a lot of insight in how the users are using your website. And if they're using it wrong or they're using it in another way that you do not want them to use, then you know what you need to change in order for them to use it the way you want it. So this is very interesting, and I'm very curious to see how this is going to develop, because at the moment it is just in beta. But that is HockeyStack's platform. Now let's dive into the pricing structure of HockeyStack, because it is a little bit confusing. The pricing structure of HockeyStack can be quite confusing. They offer 5 different plans, which is mainly differing on the amount of page views and the features. Compared to, for instance, Hotjar, they have simplified their pricing to only 2 plans, where you choose the amount of daily sessions. It's way easier to make a choice, as I can only choose between 2 plans, which is something HockeyStack should maybe think about. The help and support within HockeyStack, however, is great. They really have spent a tremendous amount of time on creating a big knowledge base to lighten the pressure on the support. I found endless amount of answers within their knowledge base, and when I needed help from their support, I got answers the same day, so it was really great. The competitors to HockeyStack, as I see it right now, is Hotjar and InfluencerSoft, whereas InfluencerSoft is probably the closest one. If you want, you can see the video review I've made of InfluencerSoft up here in the corner. Hotjar is more a recording tool where they record the visitors, and they do also have the survey element, whereas InfluencerSoft is way more all around, building the goals, the funnels, and so much more, as HockeyStack is doing. The way that HockeyStack is utilizing their funnel and goal module makes it so much easier to measure your performance of your marketing campaigns. It requires no coding knowledge at all, and it's so easy to set up. Whereas InfluencerSoft, they do it in a different way. It is also very easy to set up, but they do it with their visual funnel builder, where you can basically drag and drop steps for the different forms and what needs to happen with the forms, the actions, triggers, and so much more. Both ways works great, and it's an easy way to measure the performance of your marketing campaigns. Taking a look into the future of HockeyStack, it is quite exciting. They're working on integrations, of course, to Zapier, but a lot other elements that will make it possible for you to easily capture leads or work with leads in another way. For instance, of course, you can work with all of these users in a different way, but it's just an example. Furthermore, they are going to add a WordPress plugin and a Shopify app in the near future. This is almost done. What this will do is that it will make it easy for us to get started tracking our website in the near future. But if we look further ahead, this will make it possible for HockeyStack to collect even more data and know how our users are using the website and showcase this to us for us to take action and change elements that we need to change in order for the users to use it in the right way. This is very exciting, and I'm very curious to see how they are going to succeed with this. Furthermore, they are adding automatic funnels combined with the Insights module, as I just shown you. This means that HockeyStack will be able to suggest automatic funnels for you, and all you have to do is just click yes or no whether you want to track it or not. This is also, again, a great way to see if you have funnels of your website that you were not aware of, or there are funnels that you didn't want to happen, which has happened, which means that you need to change something on your website. The last module they're going to add in the near future is the comparison module. This will make it possible for you to compare 2 periods up against each other. So imagine that you run a marketing campaign with a specific design in 1 period, and then the next period you change the design a little bit. then you will be able to compare those two periods against each other and see what performed best, and then of course go with the solution that performed the best. Looking further into the future, they are adding automatic form tracking. This means that they will scan your entire website, find all the forms, and then start tracking them for you. This means that you don't have to think about tracking your forms, and often 9 out of 10 times a form is a conversion, so this is a great way to also set up goals automatically for you. Furthermore, they're adding elements like a real-time view where you can see your users in real time. They're adding a lot of e-commerce features so you can, in your funnels, say that they need to add a certain product to the cart and they need to check out afterwards. That's a very easy funnel, but they're adding the elements so it's possible for you. Furthermore, they're adding interactive goal definition. This means that imagine that you are on your website with a tool right at hand, then you will be able to click on the different elements that needs to be a goal, which means that you will have the tool and you will click on, for instance, your form if you want your form to be a goal. And this is what they mean by interactive goal definition. Last but not least, they will add a Google Analytics integrations, which will just make it possible for them to utilize the data even more. And this will just benefit you so much in the long run, because all of the data that Google Analytics gathers in, they will be able to put into their machinery and then suggest you elements or changes you might need to do to your website. So this is also exciting to see. My experience using HockeyStack so far has been great. Their functionality is on point and it's really working. It is tracking very well. However, I hope they will improve their UX in the near future, because it is a bit buggy and a bit unresponsive time to time. But again, the functionality is great, and that is what matters when it comes to tracking your marketing performance. But all of the modules and the way they work so seamlessly together with the goal module and the funnel module makes it so easy to use HockeyStack today. So yeah, that's my review of HockeyStack, a great tracking tool for your website. I hope that you liked the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions to HockeyStack or other products you would like me to review, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.